MapReduce Overview. MapReduce is a programming model for processing large data sets with a parallel distributed algorithm on a cluster. In our case, the Hadoop Distributed File System, HDFS, is used, and this provides a cluster of commodity quality data nodes over which the blocks of the files are distributed. A MapReduce program comprises a map procedure or routine that performs extraction, filtering and sorting, and a reduce procedure that performs a summary operation. The MapReduce infrastructure or framework coordinates and controls the distributed servers, running the various tasks in parallel, managing all communications and data transfers between the various parts of the system, providing for redundancy and fault tolerance, and overall management of the whole system. The model is inspired by map and reduce functions commonly used in functional programming, although their purpose in the MapReduce framework is not the same as their original forms. All the same, functional programming breaks down a problem into a set of functions that take inputs and produce outputs, and that is the origin of the approach. The key contributions of the Hadoop MapReduce framework are not the actual map and reduce functions, since you supply differing map and reduce functions, generally in the form of Java classes, depending on the work that needs to be done, but the scalability and fault tolerance achieved for a variety of applications by optimizing the execution engine once. In addition to the framework, you supply for each specific problem the mapper algorithm or piece of code, the reducer algorithm, and any appropriate parameters. The name MapReduce generally refers to a proprietary Google technology, but has since been genericized. After completing this topic, you'll be able to describe and explain the term map in regard to Hadoop. Describe and explain the term reduce in regard to Hadoop. Describe how the job tracker and task trackers work with MapReduce, and explain the fault tolerance capabilities of MapReduce. There is a single job tracker for the cluster. Each data node on the cluster has a task tracker, and thus there are multiple task trackers, possibly dozens, hundreds, or thousands, depending upon the number of nodes in the cluster. What is MapReduce? It's a way to process large data sets by distributing the work across a large number of nodes. Prior to executing the mapper function, the master node partitions the input into smaller subproblems, which are then distributed to the worker nodes. The job tracker runs on the master node, and a task tracker works on each data or worker node. Worker nodes may themselves act as master nodes in that they in turn may partition the subproblem into even smaller subproblems. In the reduce step, the master node takes the answers from all of the mapper subproblems and combines them in such a way as to get the output that solves the problem. Let's look at an analogy to understand the concept. For the moment, forget about Hadoop. Let's look at the MapReduce paradigm in something more familiar, a relational database. Since this is an IBM course, DB2 will be used in this example, but any other relational database management system closely follows suit. Assume that you have a massively parallel processing database environment. This is similar to an Hadoop cluster in that you have multiple machines or nodes working together. Next, assume that you have an employee table that is partitioned across multiple nodes in your DB2 system. This is just a somewhat technical way of saying that portions of the employee table reside on various nodes in the database cluster, although to the user, the employee table appears as a single entity. A client program connects to the coordinator node and sends a request to total the number of employees in each job classification. The coordinator node in turn sends that request to each of the nodes on which a portion of the employee table resides. Since for this request there is no inter-data dependencies, each sub-agent is able to process the request against its portion of the table in parallel with all the other sub-agents. Each sub-agent reads through the portion of the employee table that it stores and extracts the job classification for each employee. Then each sub-agent sorts the results in job classification sequence. Each sub-agent reads through the sorted results, counting the number of records for each job classification. Finally, each sub-agent sends, for each job classification, a single record back to the coordinator node with the job classification value and its number of occurrences. Once the coordinator node has all the results from the sub-agents, it is able to then sort the records on job classification and come up with a total for each job classification. The coordinator then returns its results to the client. In this example, the work done by the sub-agents is the mapping phase. The work handled by the coordinators is the reduce phase. The analogy breaks down somewhat in the case of Hadoop MapReduce, in that Hadoop MapReduce generally provides multiple reducer tasks to finalize the result and the output. Note that a unified result, one output file, is not a requirement for the output Hadoop MapReduce, but you could, if you wish, require that only one MapReduce task run. It all depends on what you need to get done. With large problems, you might prefer the output files themselves to be distributed across the Hadoop distributed file system, as the output of this MapReduce job may be the input to a separate and later MapReduce job or another job. This chaining of jobs can be done with OOSI or other job coordination frameworks. We will continue in the next video.